In this program, we are going to swap two numbers using the single procedure. So here we are starting off with our code. You can see in our data part, in our data segment, we are declaring two variables and initializing them with an int 20. And this is inside my dot code segment, and above my main procedure, we do the declaration of our function to be used after the main. Or defined after the main. So this is the, you can see, data type prototype. This is my name of the function, and this proto means that this is just a prototype, not the actual definition. And here you can see I am taking no any parameters because I am going to use these a and b in my swap procedure as well, right? As they're accessible to that part as well, you must know this. So inside my main, what I'm doing, I'm just invoking my this swap procedure, and I'm not passing any arguments. I don't need to pass these two arguments explicitly because they are already accessible, because this is declared in the data part, so it is accessible in all the other procedures as well, right? So I don't need to pass them by here or pass by any parameters, right? So I'm just simply taking the function's name, that is swap. After this, I'm calling the, you can say, writing that very value on the screen, whatever is returned by the procedure. And here you can see this is basically a call CRLF, which is used to move the text to the next line. And here I'm again calling that same procedure. I'm calling the same procedure two times, right? Normally we call every procedure only once, but why I'm calling it two times? You also need to call it only two times, because swapping means what? That we have to display both numbers. This a will be replaced by 20, so I have to display 20 first, and then I have to display 10 also. So if you just call it for once, it will just display me the very recent value, that is, it will just display the swapped value of a, that will be 20. It will just display 20, it will not display 10. But I want my both values to be displayed so that I can prove that the values are swapped, right? So you have to call this function two times. First time while you call this function, that call write int will you can say show the value of the first variable or the first register, and on the second call it will display the value of the second register that was not displayed by the previous time, right? It will display as the next value, it will display as the value that is not displayed yet. Means both times two different values will be displayed by the compiler, okay? So that's why we need two function calls here. So now coming towards the actual code of the main swap procedure, this is very simple. What you need to do, you just need two variables because we are going to swap two numbers. So we have to you have to keep two our registers. So first see this part. What I am doing, my a is containing 10 normally and my b is containing 20 in the above declaration we have seen. So I am moving the value of a, that is 10, in my EBX, and I am moving the value of my B, which was 20, in EX, right? EBX is holding the value A and EAX is holding the value B, right? So now how I want to display on the screen, I want that my this B becomes the A and my this A becomes this B, right? So here you can see A becomes 20 and B becomes 10 by these two lines of code. So you can see over here, firstly I am moving the first value in EBX and my second value in the some other register, right? You definitely have to perform these two steps to perform the swapping. And next, what we are doing, you can say that my A is containing previously what? It is containing 10, and now inside my 10 I am moving B. Why B? Because EX is containing 20, right? So I am moving EX in A, which means A was previously what? It was 10. It was 10, right? And now I am moving EX value in A, and EX was 20. That is, I have moved B in EX, right? So EX is 20. It means after this movement, my A is containing what? It becomes 20, and previously in our initialization A was what? It was 10, right? I hope you are getting me because this is not so difficult. And inside this, definitely if you have seen this step, then you can definitely guess this one, that now I have to move. Definitely I have moved 20 over here, so I need to move 10 over here. And 10 is stored in which register? See, from here 10 is stored in EBX, right? So I am moving that EBX value in B. So now my B becomes 10 and my A becomes 20. This is very simple. You have to move these two register values in A. But before that, you need to perform these two steps that you can say storing the original values of A and B in EBX and EX, and then moving them vice versa. That you can see here, we were removing the value of P in EAX, right? And now we are moving that EX value, that is 20, in A, and we are moving EBX value, that is 10, in B. And this return means this will just return the value of the very first variable, that is 20. On the first call, we will get 20 over here. This 20 will be displayed. On the second call, we know that there is still one element left to be displayed. So in the next call, this 20 won't be displayed again. Rather, this 10 will be displayed and returned by this. So by this call right end, we will display 10 on the screen. Right? So I hope you have gotten it. Let's run it. It should display us 20 and 10 after the swap. Okay, so you can see the values of A and B are successfully swapped, right? So that's it for this program. So I will see you next time, and make sure to stay tuned for these more programs. So thank you so much.